Welcome everyone to Neverwinter on PC. My name is Reiner, and today I'm going to give you an update on MOD 13. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, and if you would like to see more informational videos about Neverwinter, hit the subscribe button. I've been gone for a bit. I have been upgrading my DC on the live server for Tongue, and I'm mainly waiting for the new MOD 13 lockbox on the previous server, which I, of course, will thoroughly investigate, as you are used to from me. The last patch on the previous server has brought some changes. Apart from a couple of big control wizard nerfs, there is also some positive news. One is a bit personal. Since the last three treasure maps from the patrol quests have been added. I have found, mapped and sent them to my buddy from the Unblocked website, so expect those map updates there soon. Another less personal update is that the lures and trophies are not unique anymore, which is great. As you can see here, I have two of the same lures in my inventory and also two of the same trophies in my inventory. On a side note, it seems that this Razor Tyrannus is actually quite a bit easier to solo than the Tyrannosaurus Rex from Soshin Star. Which is, I don't know if that's a good sign, but I'm fine with that. I guess they will die very quickly, now that they're so easy. So, today, apart from these updates, we are going to solo three of the new hunts. Polaris, I have two, let's do them twice. I have the Redfang lure, and I have the Maita lure. I have never done them before, so let's see what they are like. I apologize if my keyboard is a bit loud during the fights. I have a mechanical keyboard, and I have to enhance the volume after recording in order for you guys to properly hear me. So yeah, you will know that. I will go to the first hunt, clear the area, and then we're going to fight Polaris first. Alright, this is the location of the Polaris hunt, it's down here. You can also find it, of course, in the maps that I made. I have him twice. I hope the Razor Tyrannus doesn't spawn while we're doing the hunt. But let's do this one. I think it's some kind of bear, because, yeah, he's a bear. Let's see how easy it is to solo. Seems to be quite easy, to be honest. I'm not even using my artifact. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Got two items. Melee powers do 3% more damage. That sounds good. I think I'm going to use this one. So, to make this clear, I am on the preview server, and my item level is actually a little bit lower than on the live server here. I do have some rank 14 enchantments, which I do not have on the live server. I think it's relatively accurate compared to the live server how quickly these die. I think this artifact, this new artifact equipment, the primal equipment, is not very good during soloing because it doesn't work on self-healing as far as I know. But yeah, I got them. It just means I don't get the 10% bonus damage. So let's do this one more time. Should be pretty simple. Let's do the outfit this time. Let's do the next. Yeah, he definitely doesn't have a lot of health. Ring of the Herb Mocker. Hit points and defense. We have shield all time, HP, your defense is increased by 700. Okay. Maybe something for a paladin. or no, actually more for a Guardian fighter, but nothing for me. So that was Polaris. Let's go to Redfang. Oh. So here's the Razor Tyrannus Rex. I'm gonna show you that it's quite easy to solo. If I don't die here, that'll be fun. I did notice that these guys have the beam attack from the King of Spines heroic encounter, which is a bit annoying, that's quite a bit of damage. But as I said, they have a lot less health than the T-Rex. Got one extra spine, so now I have three. All right, let's go to, what was it, Razor Claw? All right, I messed up that name a minute ago, so it is Redfang. Redfang spawns here, and for him you need this Tyrannosaur tail meat. Let's see what this guy's like. Okay. He also seems to have a really low amount of HP. He's already dead. So these one star hunts seem to be very simple. The third one, so we got a ring of the Death Dasher here. Something when your health is below X percent, your movement is increased, power recovery. Eh, not that great. Alright, so now I'm going to the last guy, Maita. He's also under here, he should be here. I'll be back. Alright. I've cleared the area here again. This is the Maita hunt location. It's here. Let's see what this guy is like. That's good. What's this? When you're hit at 25% or lower, your deflection increases. If you have less than 5000 deflection, you will gain 2500 for 5 seconds. Okay. Not sure who would like to have something like that. I don't think anyone. Lifekeeper. Also not very good. Alright, so the items from these hunts are not that great, but as you could see, they're pretty simple to solo. Not much CC, not that much hit points. Yeah, that's it. In the next video I will do some other hunts. I guess I will do the other 5 tier 1 hunts, and next week maybe I will do the tier 2 hunts. Yeah. So guess that's it. If you have any remarks on this video or any suggestions on what to investigate next, Feel free to leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.